Here we are again. Welcome to this second lesson on technology transfer. As for what was done during the first hour spent together, also for the second part, I will try to explain to you, being in 45-50 minutes. We will pick up where we left off with a very brief review of the topics we have seen, and we will begin to tackle also with the help of some specialist studies examples, case studies, new more interactive topics involving technology transfer, and more specifically, information retrieval methods. I will therefore say to begin this second part. Let's have a quick reading of what will be the contribution of the second part of the lesson. Therefore, we will start with a little relative analysis about a brief summary of what we saw in the first lesson. Then I will show you a new approach for the extraction of specific technical features. That is to say, informations from a corpus text taken from databases and comprising different kinds of document, text, data sources. This methodology is divided into the parts that are shown in the slide. So a very brief and general introduction in order to contextualize the methodology. The methodology, of course, a brief analysis, just to remind you what are the technical features. Then we will see a practical tool, very important, used for the comparison of products through technical requirements, that is called market potential technique. And at the end, last but not least, the innovative contribution of the research compared to pre-existing works in the state of the art. Okay, so now let's see very briefly what we saw in the first lesson, so we can continue with this second lesson about technology transfer and information retrieval methods. So during the first lesson, we saw the technology transfer. As many of you right now certainly know, technology transfer is the process that with knowledge, technologies, production methods, but also prototypes, and so on, so services developed by universities, academia, companies, public and research bodies, and private research bodies can be made accessible to a wide range of users who can then further develop and exploit technology to create new products, processes, services, materials, applications, and so on. When I refer as technologies, I refer to some techniques, skills, methods, and processes using the production of goods or services, or of course in the accomplishment of objectives such as scientific investigation. While technology can be the knowledge of techniques, processes, and the like, or it can be embedded in technical systems, in machines, to allow for operation without detailing knowledge of the workings. Okay, so we then saw which are the challenges right now for technology transfer and the different approaches in the state of the art used for for the analysis. So let's start seeing the research objective. Well, it can be summarized as a way of facilitating technology transfer process by proposing and developing a methodology based on documentary sources, just to remind you, such as, for instance, papers, utility patents, and so on. Firstly, for the search, and then the categorization of possible new application fields of a given technology. I mentioned that the objective of the research is to facilitate technology transfer. Of course, the finite process of transferring technology from the organization that owns the knowledge to another organization, and this may occur between universities and companies and so on. In the infographic that I have reported in the lower part of the slide, I have, I have tried to schematize the focal contents related to the research objectives and also a preview of what will be the methodological content resulting from the study conducted in this year of my doctorate. These arguments will be the core of the next slides of this presentation. The contribution of the research consists in categorize, compare, propose, and improve methods and tools to support and facilitate technology transfer. Of course, it should be said that more subjects benefit from technology transfer activity. In particular, how to discover new business opportunities and how to decide which one are worth pursuing has become nowadays an increasingly common and crucial question for the survival of many companies that now have an established technology in a saturated market. Therefore, the contribution of the research aims to support technology transfer by means of services and methodologies for finding new potential market application, you know, in a more generic way, we will refer it as an outward technology transfer, OTT. So for finding new potential market application and tools for ranking and evaluating the most promising business directions. Services and methodologies offer guidelines for finding new interesting business developments, evaluating the convenience of replacing technologies, while tools are designed for speeding up and increasingly increasing the quantity and quality of the research for easy made and experimental technological solution for industrial problems. Okay, so from now on, I will present the methodology through which I carried out the research and experimentation of the phases mentioned before. I think it is essential to outline the steps that make up the methodology in the figure in the infographic scheme reported in the slide on the slide. So the goal of the methodology is to suggest a novel documentary sources-based approach for automatizing the extraction of a list of alternative technological opportunities. It is based on a function approach embedded with the syntactic parsers and other natural language processing applications. They were also used to assess the different opportunities and suggest which one of them have the greatest potential for success in the market. The proposed method for identifying a ranking, so rank is very important thing also in this matter. New technology application is articulated into three main steps. Every steps, each one of these steps have different sub-step, but let's start with seeing these main groups classification. So the first one concerns the definition of the pool and the selection of the proper technology. Definition of the pool of document text, so query that enter into a patent database in order or a scientific papers repository database in order to find the specific documents in order to create the initial collection of documents to be analyzed. And of course, the selection of the proper technology, technology that can be given by that born from an academic or an industrial problems, industrial issues. While step two use semantics to identify new technology applications. So with semantics and natural language processing, we enter in a test, we understand each word inside the corpus test and tie them together in order to extract new, the output of the research, the main output of the research is to identify new technological applications. Application, when I say application, I mean products. Products that can be an heating pad, for instance, for the heating fabric application, where in this case the technologies are, for instance, the copper wire in order to heat a surface or an object, without versus a new technology that can be an alternate technology that is the carbon wire heating fabric application. So the goal of this step is to find all functions for a given product and use them for identify potential transfer application. So the function, in this case, for instance, when I refer obviously to knitting pad, can be heat, can be dry, can be produce, can be, so these are actions that we have to take into consideration. Heat is a good example in this case. In the last box on the right, the technology to be transferred is compared with the existing technologies and measured by a quantitative transfer index. In this case, we have different the different products that we have identified are ranked together in order to find the most promising to propose to an industry that can obviously guide the investments and decide to produce this kind of product. So provide a technical ranking in order to find the most promising potential application or product for what we have seen, what we have found together. Unlike many other methods, working with the same tool or the same data source, the proposed approach does not require any inventive contribution of the user, from the user, nor any particular experience in the specific field of application. So everyone potentially can see this, but so they have not, they don't need to be to have any vetting contribution from the user that are actually working on this methodology, and of course not any particular experience in this specific field of application, because the specific field of application can be whatever we can identify, because it depends on the technology that the industries can give us. So the given technology are a multitude and very different to each other. So back, and then we finish with this slide that we have out of time. So from the analysis of the verbs, all those that are not inherent of an OTT goal have been manually discarded. So there is, of course, a project, jointly collaboration with an expert in order to identify from the text and discharge the functional verbs that are not relevant for the analysis that we are taking, that we are doing. So in fact, the majority of the functions are related to actions that are made to produce or modify the fabric itself, while we are all interested on those actions that the fabric is able to produce on a third object, and on which the enabling technology, heating, in this case, for example, has a direct relevance. Okay, the first step in identifying the pool of pertinent documents from which to extract all technological features for making technology transfer. So, identifying the pool of pertinent documents, circumscribe the pool of documents, patent, for example, in this case, in order to work with this methodology. So for this task, the patent database is one of the most suitable tool because it encompasses all technological fields. Other tools consulted are scientific papers, but in order to build the number of documents that will be processed, a set of documents containing a series of keywords that could identify the technology source are identified. But it is very important to highlight that these keywords must be sufficiently generalized in order to not limit the search field too much, because otherwise the solution that we identify from the documents that correspond to the research of these keywords are very a limited pool and not sufficiently exhaustive of the technology. So it is possible to work with the entire dataset consisting in over 100 million patents, or by choosing statistically relevant and representative subsets of the entire databases, such as the WIPO database or the USTPO database or the entire EPO. SpaceNet, which count a more limited number of documents. In our case, we use the FAMPAT database because it is very accessible and very precise in order to find the documents. And so in order to limit the number of documents to be processed by syntactic parsers, we identified a narrow set of patents containing a series of keywords that could circumscribe the technology source that can be sufficiently generalized, not to limit the search field too much. Other document sources analyzed are scientific papers, databases, and commercial catalogs of companies. Okay, so after building the document pool, the next steps are aimed at identifying potential products. To do so, the second step of the methodology consists in the analysis of the text with the aim of finding functions related to the technology under analysis from the pool of documents. With the term function, I mean the purpose of the design object, and from a linguistic point of view, this can be seen as a verb. So, the objective is always the same, and it is to extract from a test a list of functions related to the technology under analysis. To do so, It is necessary to take the document pool and analyze it semantically. The document pool, it was identified in the step one, from pattern databases. And this second step, in order to find the action, the functions, this can be done by using semantic software that process the natural language of a text. The process carried out by this program is divided into several phases, from lexical to semantic analysis. But what is interesting to have as output for the purpose of the methodology is that the text is broken down word by word, and that at each one of them, at each word, is assigned a semantic meaning. So, what is it? It is a semantic analysis of the corpus test where the natural language process identify the semantic meaning of the words and tie them together in order to extract information useful for the analysis that we are taking. So, in this way, it is possible to recognize entities and semantic relations. However, the semantic process cannot be entirely automated and still requires different expertise. So, once I have finished analyzing the text from a semantic point of view, it follows the phase of identification of the functions that are extracted not only on pre-existing techniques, but also to other semantic relationships. Okay, let's take a moment in order to see more in detail. So, as you can see in the first figure here, this is actually a corpus of pattern text where the various sections that we are taking into consideration from a pattern are the title, the abstract, the pattern class, claims, and also the description that is important. But one of the most important things to consider from a patent, if we are not deciding to take the entire corpus text, the entire patent text, is the claims, the claims for the patent. Okay, then the second process in this matter is to analyze the text. And here I have reported three examples. So for example, the first phrase is a heating fabric can still conduct that we are taking into that we are extracted from the text. And for each word, I know that heating fabric is a noun, can auxiliary, adverb, and verb. So in this case, the software identify conduct, printing, and melt, and automatically extract this verb and take into my consideration. Then I have to analyze these verbs a little bit manually in order to find that they are efficiently referring to the subject that I want, that is eating fabric. And then I filter them in order to consider only the verb that I have that are important for this analysis. Okay, the identification of the application fields is one of the most complex targets to identify. When I refer to application, actually, I mean not only application, but also products, let's say. So different applications are associated to different functions, but also same function can be used in various domains. To automatically extract application areas, I semantically process document text containing the functions previously identified. So here the objective, the goal is to find the function in order to extract products. For this case, also in this case, I propose a novel semantic technique to be integrated with pre-existing ones. So for each function that I identified, for instance, melt or eat, to melt, to dry, a routine is launched. For each function, a routine is launched that takes advantage of the provided dependency parser list to identify the products. Again, no sector-specific expertise is required. The dependency parsers list we can see here in the second figure that you can see that are, for instance, as pew noun to pew noun. So verb, the software search inside the pattern test the verb plus as plus noun. And I identify, in this case, the products. So the process starts with the function identified, then with the use of semantics, I extract all the dependency patterns that in the end are used together with the functions to find the products of the technology under analysis. In this case, the classic SAO approach that we saw in the previous lesson, so the subject action object triads, is capable of finding all verbs that are related to our technology. However, not all verbs are interesting about outward technology transfer. So the knowledge that I have for a specific study and research of a given technology, I put this knowledge in order to find a new product application different from the initial products in which the technology initially have. It is the outward technology transfer that is different from inward technology transfer. So, as first step, we have to filter the list by selecting only functional verbs. For instance, those verbs that imply a change of parameters on the object to which they refer. To do this, special language libraries that classify verbs into categories and select only the most technical categories are used. The novelty of this methodology lies in the extension of the search not only to SAO triads, but also to other semantic relationships to be searched in combination with dependency parser. For reason of brevity, we limit ourselves to pointing out those that have the best results among the dozen of reports that we have been tested. So among them, there are the following forms that I have reported here in the slide that are two plus verb, four plus verb, or the model, all model verbs, so can plus verb, by plus verb, use for, or as, of, should, plus verb, that are the dependency parser that are used for every technology in order to find products starting from a function that is extracted through semantics. Each one of them was chosen only if there was at least one relationship with EDIC fabric, that is the technology that we have taken into consideration before starting the analysis. So in order to increase the probability that the function plus object was referred, able to give them the technology. Okay, so important concept here before going forward to the next slide is that the application identification is based on each function, and for each function, a routine is launched that takes advantages of the provided dependency parsers list that we can see here in the second slide to identify the products. Okay, in order to, right now we have identified products from a technology based on patents, the information that we have found on patents. But right now, in order to measure the potential of the technology to be transferred, a comparison with its alternative technologies is conducted for the identified applications. With more details, alternative technologies are those technologies that can perform the same function in a certain field of application. Compare these technologies, it is necessary to identify requirements for comparison. First, alternative technologies have to be identified for each domain. Secondly, semantics also in this case helps in identifying requirements to be used as comparison factors. So the requirements are, for instance, fire resistant, hydrophobicity, thermal conductivities, breathability, inflexibility, and so on. Here I have reported in this figure just for 8 examples. But the technical requirements that I use to compare the technology, the product of two alternative technologies, change for the different technologies for. So each technology have different technical requirements. So it is important to use the semantics in order to extract the technical requirements that are suitable for the technical analysis and the ranking of the potential application that we have identified. After that, so we have found the requirements. In order to make a comparison of the application, I used a tool that already exists in the state of the art called Market Potential, developed by Ulwick, that can be used as an indicator to compare the ability of different products to satisfy the requirements that I have identified through semantics. So in the methodology, the only known original part is the market potential, but unlike the traditional approach, requirements are extracted semantically without involving experts. They will only be involved at a later stage and will be asked to assess the requirements for each application. Finally, a transfer potential indicator is proposed to measure the potential of technology substitution. Okay, let's see with more detail what is this technology market potential technique. As I mentioned earlier, marketers use various market potential estimation techniques in international markets. This includes method of analogy, proxy indicators, chain ratio model, time series analysis, and also multiple regression modeling. This study in particular shows how demand or market potential can be estimated using those methods and compare the findings. The study should be useful to both managers and academics interested in the theory and the practice of demand estimation. Although emerging markets and durables are used as examples, the methods discussed are universal and can be applied in any country market. So marketers have undertaken primary and secondary research to estimate the demand or market potential for goods and services in international market. In this regard, it would be hard to find any model or method that is flawless. Usually, the need of the researcher and the problem relating to estimation make one method more desirable over the other. The problem related to estimation include precision in estimation, predictive power of the model, feasibility in design and implementation. But also, let me say, data availability and cost benefit of the research. Evolutionary studies help us understand what parameters we need to consider when evaluating the maturity of a product and how research and how strategic it can be looked for this information in the budget source. The question of how to manage the evaluation of a multi-criteria analysis remains open. This is why we have consider the market potential method. So the market potential consists of a dual analysis where we assess satisfaction and importance of requirements from a customer perspective. Importance is the degree, importance on the third row is the degree of requirement to influence the customer decision. This importance also consider company investments made by improved requirements. So a 0 to 100% scale is used where 0% is not important and 100% is absolutely important. On the same, satisfaction measure the capability of a technology to fill or overcome customer expectation for a specific requirement. Differently from the importance, that only depends on the application that is a unique parameter for all technologies, satisfaction assessed for each technology. More in practical term, the advent of semantics has transformed the potential of research, allowing us to obtain level of precision that are unthinkable until now. So the basic idea is to exploit this technology to produce graphics with high granularity and high precision, which can be used as quantitative comparison tools. First of all, an attempt is made to create the pool with maximum recall extracted by content analysis tools, the basic concept in a fast and efficient way. These first screenings helps to enter the subject, to find connections that are not obvious even for experts in the sector, and help not to lose potential requirements to be evaluated in the market potential that may not have come up in a preliminary planning. In some cases, obviously, a manual refinement is still necessary or a combination of the two techniques. But the fact of being able to work with semantics offers the undisputed advantage of almost always working with pertinent document. It's followed then the phase of requirements evaluation with expert in the fields. Among the various approaches used to evaluate market potential, a technique consists in the evaluation and definition of a series of customer needs and requirements with a structured procedure to translate them into technical parameters and plans to produce products that essentially meet those needs. Benchmarking is obviously one of the most of the first form of structured product development. products are compared in the benchmarking method with industry best from other companies, and improvements are planned to cover possible gaps or to overcome competitors' performances. In particular, satisfaction is a measure of how customer needs are supplied by company meter or surpass customer expectations. As shown in the example reported in the figure above, the slide, the products that own the greater market potential is the product that represent a combination of greater importance and lower satisfaction level among the various requirements treated. Okay, so now, after presenting the methodology, in this slide, I reported the innovative contribution of the research, but compared to literature. So there are two fundamental aspects to take into consideration, starting with the first one that is related to the functional search based on documentary sources. So compared to pre-existing techniques, the research proposes an integration among different tools with the aim of systematizing and enhancing technological features. Extraction are the opposite of pre-existing techniques of parameters in a text. Secondly, in comparison to existing methods for the study of technology substitution, the research does not require an investing contribution from the user and often universally applied to any technological context. As I previously said, as for the limitation of the work so far, the methodology has been tested on a case study regarding a well-known technology, but in addition, the research work with cases where there are two competing technologies. Different, of course, will be the case where no alternative technologies already exist. In this case, we have to consider other strategies in order to perform the analysis, but it's not an impossible task also for this case. So finally, another limitation related to the domain of application. If there are a large number of alternative technologies, the complexity, of course, and time needed to perform the analysis could be affected. But speaking about the improvements, it is very important to analyze critical analysis of the work. One way of overcoming an existing limitation is to test the methodology with new case studies, hopefully very different from each other. Another possible improvement is related to the exploitation of semantics in order to extract parameters. At the end, suggest a quantitative indicator that measures the potential substitution of a new technology compared to an existing one. In conclusion, the research conducted proposes a novel approach based on documentary sources to automatize the extraction of these technological opportunities and evaluate the convenience of a technological substitution. The activities carried out started with proposing alternative ways of solving existing limitation and identifying during the first steps. The research has also been able to demonstrate how the method can provide useful results to identify potential application in an industrial case study based on the substitution of copper technology with carbon fiber on products containing chitin fabric. And more important, the proposed approach does not require an inventive contribution from the users and nor any particular experience in the specific field of application because the parameters are automatically extracted from the pool of documents. Okay, so Also, the second part of the lesson is also over. Thank you very much for your attention. In this slide, you will find my contacts. And again, I will be happy to answer if there are any questions or ideas for discussion on this part. I remain available at the email you find reported. I thank you again for these 2 hours that we spent together, even if at a distance, and I greet you. Bye bye.